Hi, hello everyone. So in this video, I will show you the Tesla on the autopilot camera calibration process. As you can see in the tablet now, in Tesla, that we have the autopilot tab, which the camera right now is calibrated for about 97%. So we need to drive a little bit more in the town, in the distance area, so you calibrate all the dividers, the road sign, the lines and everything, then it will be able to run on the autopilot, which is more on the intelligent cruise control with the line keep and all this. Okay, we'll show you when it's complete. So while we are driving, the system is actually calibrating. Now it's 99%, it's still calibration in progress. I think 1% more to go, then we should be able to activate the autopilot navigation. It's not available, but then the auto cruise control is available. Okay, so now finally, after more than half an hour of driving calibration, the calibration is completed now, and you can see it's already completed. Now my friend, can you help me to hold the camera? I have to take a little bit small risk on that, and now I'm going to activate the autopilot. So now I will just, the car should be driven by itself. Of course I can adjust the speed over here or here. Yeah, on this, so I can adjust my speed. Now I maintain at about 90, and then the vehicle in the front, I'm not sure how is the distance can be adjusted. Yep, now I can reduce the distance to level 1, 2, 3. So just by simply tap the tap to left to increase the distance so that I can have a safer distance. Or this one. Yep. Okay, so now you can see virtually I'm doing nothing on the steering wheel, and I am, the car in the front is slowing down, and it slowed down by itself. It's set at 92, now it's 57 up the hill. It's not bad. And actually the road lane is not really that clear. We will test in the front and see whether which line you will follow, because there is some corner on the bridge which is upcoming. So personally, now this is engaging the autopilot. If you press only one time, that is actually some sort of ACC, adaptive cruise control, that you can just maintain the distance with the front vehicle. But right now, as you can see, that even the steering is steered by itself. Okay, so we will see whether this corner, is steered by itself, and we have a traffic jam in front. So not bad at all. It's steered by itself, it slowed down by itself, it braked by itself, and we will see whether it will brake until it stop and follow by itself, or we need to have the accelerator pedal. Right now I'm doing nothing on this Tesla Model 3, so we will see. Okay, slowing down, and now it's just follow. So we still have about 17, 18, 19 kilometers. And I can take back on this camera. Okay, you can see it's even detecting it's a truck. Okay, so that is the amazing part. I did nothing. No acceleration. Nothing. Okay. All by itself, we can see the car is coming to the stop. Now it's 48, 47. Now the vehicle is stopped. Slowing down. The motorcycle is passing between of the road. Okay, it's all done. Sorry, my friend is picking out the phone. Okay, so now you can see it's going in. Very nice.
Okay, okay. Alright.
Okay, and as you can see now, we are maintaining this lane. Basically now it's autopilot without navigation. So the car in the front is cutting in, and you can also see it's slowing down and maintain the distance all by itself. I really do nothing. Okay, so the car is still by itself, and in the front we can see now it's going on the bridge, and the bridge is turning right at quite a big angle. The normal ICC intelligent cruise control level 3 autonomous level will not be able to steer through this corner, and we will see what will happen. Okay, thanks to the nice ringtone. Okay, now we are coming into this tight corner. Not bad, not bad. Steer by yourself. Oh, I'm a little bit worried, but it's okay. Okay, so nice. In this part, I would like to show you if we press the cruise control or the autopilot one time only instead of double tap. So what will happen is one tap. Okay. Oh. Okay. Now only I tap one tap. I still have the cruise control, but the steering control is gone. Okay, you can see if I don't touch the steering, it step on the line and then it start deviating. So this is one step autopilot. If we just tuck it one time, so it will not control the steering. And if I press two times, then the steering control is coming in, and basically with this I don't have to do anything. Okay, I have the speed set at 97. I have the vehicle distance set at maybe the safer 7. So brake, accelerator, steering, all by itself when I tuck two times. Okay, usually in the normal ICC vehicle, intelligent cruise control, when the traffic is slowing down and stop stagnant like this, we will need, if the front vehicle is start moving, then we will need to give a light tap on the accelerator pedal to give a signal for it to move. But now let's see, the front vehicle is moving now already, and yeah, I don't need to give any signal, it moved by itself. Okay, it moved by itself. Okay, in this part of the video, we will show you how to engage on the autopilot function. So now let's say I'm driving on the car park very slowly, and now I should have a P button over here, as you can see. Now let's say this is a parking, and then I just click shift to reverse, just push up, and then I press on the start button. So basically, again, nothing, it will shift and drive reverse automatically into the car park by itself. Okay, so this is fully autonomous, and in fact we have one X50 next to it. So yeah, so now the car is parked right inside the parking very nicely and steering straight. So autopilot complete. Okay, so thank you everyone for watching this video, and hope that you enjoy this Tesla autopilot video in the demonstration of calibration on the road, autonomous driving, follow to start, follow to stop, impressively well done, and also the auto parking assist and auto parking functions. So these are all the functionalities with the autopilots in the Tesla Model 3. Thank you.